Okay.
Book.
So you are being recorded now. Right, good morning. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
So there are 37, 38 now, so like around 6 to go. And how are you? Again. So it's all is good? All with Zoom?
It's good, ma'am.
It's good. It's still good yet, right? So you're not yet getting burn out, yeah? Masih menikmati, so excited with the course. And I hope you are also excited to follow this course that we have, Basic English Grammar. So today we are going to learn about pronoun. Pronouns means? What does it mean? It's home. Okay, I open the digital one. So, we are going to study through the SQL model. So, one of the models, at first, the teachers have to present. So, today, you will have the stories from your own hometown. That is Putri Serindang Bulan. Don't be cheat. Don't look at the text yet. Later you can see the text because this is the process of the learning. So, Putri Serindang Bulan, have you ever heard about that princess? Ada yang pernah dengar tentang princess itu? No?
No, ma'am, tapi lupa ceritanya.
What do you know? Just Putri Gading Cempaka?
Ya, yang legenda Sungai Serut itu, ma'am.
I see. So you know what? In my book, I took the story from Bengkulu, but not Putri Gading Cempaka, but Putri Serindang Bulan. And this story has also been presented by me in my presentation at Leeds Beacon University in UK, like few years ago. So, sengaja bawa Putri Serindang Bulan because I'm from Bengkulu and I said this is the story from my homeland, and they are really excited to know the story, you know. Which is kalau bagi kalian ya Putri Serindang Bulan ya sudahlah Putri Serindang Bulan begitu kan. But they are excited. At that time it was the presentation was followed, or the audience was the teachers and the professors at the university. No one is Indonesian or all bule. All of them are bule. So I am so excited. It's great. So I'm going to also present it to you today. Yeah. So you got the text already, but you may not see it yet. So now I'm gonna read it to you. You listen to the words and the pronunciation and the pronoun. So you should open page 22. So you go to page 22. You got the book, yes? Putri Serindang Bulan, ya. Cantik ya. Kayak putri itu cantik ya. So see, this is it. This is the story. Can you see it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't she pretty?
Yes.
Kan? Cantik kan?
Yes.
Pretty, ma'am.
Yeah, so I'm gonna read the story for you. And what you have to do is to fill in the pronoun as usual. Yeah, just like the previous meeting, you fill in the word you hear that is pronoun, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna read it for you. You listen to the story, but I'm going to show that every of the pictures. So, Putri Serindang Bulan, Princess atau Putri Serindang Bulan, was the daughters of King Mawang. Yeah, the kingdom was in Lebong, Bengkulu. So, anyone from Lebong, you should know this. So the princess was the youngest child, and she had six older brothers. Older brothers, and the king was dying. You know, Dying tahu ya? The king was dying. He suffered from illness and no one could cure him. Sadly, after the months of trying to give him the best medicine, the king died. The eldest son became the new king. Jika ada pronoun, tebak saja, tidak usah ada pronoun untuk apa, just you know, as seperti pengetahuan Anda saja sebelum belajar, ya. Right? So, Putri Serindang Bulan was very beautiful. Of course, a princess is beautiful, ya. The new king, her brother, wanted her to get married soon. What are you waiting for? You are old enough to get married, said the king, her brother, yeah. And he continued, there is a young friend, a prince from a neighboring kingdom who wants to be your husband. He will come tomorrow. Get ready yourself. And then the princess was hopeless. So she knew she could not say no to her brother. After all, he was the king. And she said, all right, I will wait for him, said the princess. At night, the princess could not sleep well. She was thinking of the prince who would propose to her. The princess was so nervous. Then something strange happened. There were red spots in all over of her body. Yeah, you're still listening, right? Not looking at the story, yes?
No, yes, ma'am.
Okay, and you understand the story, yes? And then she did not know why this had happened. On the following day, the prince came. When the prince met the princess, he was so surprised. He thought that she was not as beautiful as he had heard. He canceled the wedding proposal. The king was so embarrassed. He wanted the princess to get a medication. Strangely, the red spots were gone. She was cured before she got the medication. So, the red spots only came on whenever the prince came, yeah? Then, not long after that, another prince came to propose. Again, the princess suffered from the red spots. After the prince canceled the proposal, the red spots were gone. It continued to happen. Every time a man came to propose her, the princess suffered red spot on her skin. The king could not hold it anymore, so he thought that her disease was so embarrassing. He asked one of his soldiers to bring her to the jungle and kill her. The soldier brought the princess to the jungle. They had to cross a river. The soldier did not have the heart to kill the princess. He had an idea. My princess, there is something that I have to tell you. The king asked me to kill you because of your strange disease. I don't want to kill you. I will make you a sampan and you can grow it to save your life. The prince was so touched. She was also sad to her brother. She was also sad that her brother wanted her to die. Then the princess wrote the sampan. She arrived in a kingdom. The people took her to the king. So she came to another kingdom. And what brought you here? Asked the king. The princess told him about her disease and her brother. Don't worry, I will cure you, said the king. He was so sad to hear the princess's problem. The king actually had a magical power. He could cure the princess's illness. The princess was so happy. She fell in love with the king. The king also had the same feeling. Later, they planned to get married. The princess wanted to invite her brothers to come to her wedding. The brother was so ashamed of themselves, yeah? They felt so guilty. They decided to come because they wanted to apologize. The princess forgave them. Later, the princess became a lovable queen. She was not only beautiful, but also kind. So she's not only beautiful, but also kind. Who's the kind princess?
Serindang Bulan.
Okay. Who's the name of the king who proposed the king?
Mawang. Mawang.
King Mawang. All right. Who is King Mawang? The father or the brother?
The father.
The father. Is he still alive at that time? Is he still alive? Was he still alive when the princess got married? No, my connection is not good.
No.
No. All right. So you understand the story, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And she became a lovable queen. That is the story from Bengkulu, exactly from Lebong Regency, right? So how many pronoun did you get from the story? Yeah.
6 kinds, I think, ma'am. 6 kinds. 6 jenis.
Okay, 6 jenis.
Yeah.
6 kinds or six types.
Oh yeah, 6 types.
Alright. Okay. Oh wait, where is it? Putri Serindang Bulan. Wait. Yeah. Okay, so there are many types, yeah, and then let's see apa yang didengar pertama pronounsnya.
Her.
Her. Apa lagi?
She.
He.
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 She. She.
He.
He. He. He.
He. He.
He. He.
Okay.
There.
Okay. Many, ya. Ada he, ada she, ada apa lagi?
Ada
I,
her,
I, ya,
yes, they, my,
good, so got a lot, ya,
yeah?
Okay. So let's see to this. Now you can see the story, and I will present it to you here. See the story. The story. Of pronoun. Oh. Nah, yang nanti ini sebenarnya Anda harus boleh lihat story-nya sekarang. Boleh, you can look at the story. So you can open the book at the back of the book. Get the back, get the book at the back of the book. Get your bag and go to see the book. Indonesia bilang get the bag, get the book. Get your bag and get the book. So, okay, here we go. So the first one, she, she had she, and then he, and then him, him, then her, what, and you, you, he, yourself. Nah, ini ada yourself juga. He,
yourself,
him, yeah. Ada who, her, she lagi. More like that. Jadi yang kalian sering apa namanya? Sering gunakan di subjek atau di objek gitu ya. Objek dari kalimat. So you, she, you, okay. They, her, ini ada her. Nah, itu namanya pronoun. Nah, the princess forgave them, them juga. Later the princess became a lovable queen. She was not only beautiful but also fine. Nah, so itu seharusnya sudah ada diisi di tabel yang kedua. Yang sekarang nanti aja isi aja tuh. Ya. Nah. Baik. Sekarang yang co-construction, pada tahap co-construction di buku Anda itu ya. Because you are in a separate home, so you cannot work in a group of four. So you just take a look one sentence by yourself. And here, for example, here, she was thinking of the king who would propose her. Ya, itu ada di line 13. Nah, she di situ adalah subject personal pronoun, namanya. Nah, kenapa dia subject? Karena di depan subject pronoun singular sendiri kan? Dia sebagai subject, dia pronoun, dia singular. Oke, mengerti? Subject pronoun singular. Dia subjek posisinya, dia pronoun jenisnya kan tadi pronoun, Kemudian dia singular, satu. She. It's only one. She, ya. Nah, kemudian ada her di sini. Her. Who would propose her? Object, pronoun, singular. Because it is the object of the word who, ya. Nah, jadi itu ada dua di sini. Duanya dulu fokus ke situ, ya. Di sini ada, tipenya adalah personal pronoun singular. Jenis ini pronoun singular, tapi personal pronoun singular. Fungsinya sebagai apa? Sebagai subjek dari pronoun itu tadi, subjek dari kalimat. Namanya subjek pronoun. Kenapa subjek? Karena dia di depan verb. Paham ya konsepnya ya? Paham Nanta? Ya? Oke, kemudian ada her di sini. Her itu adalah objective personal pronoun. Nah, tipenya apa her ini? Personal pronoun singular, tapi dia objek. Kalau tadi kan subjek kan? Ini objek. Nah, ini personal pronoun singular juga. Kenapa personal pronoun singular kan satu, ya? Kemudian yang contoh seperti ini, selanjutnya, he suffer from illness and no one could cure him. He juga subjek, personal pronoun, ya? Subjektif ya, atau tadi personal pronoun singular, sama ini, subjektif personal pronoun. Nah, fungsinya sebagai pronoun, sama kayak she tadi ya. You get it? Yes? And then, him is the object, right? Kalau di sini tadi her karena cewek, di sini him because it is the object of the sentence, objective personal pronoun. Tipenya personal pronoun singular. Dan dia fungsinya sebagai objek. Nah, gitu ya. Ngerti ya cara yang begitu ya? Paham ya? It's very easy. This one is a very easy one.
Berarti ada bentuk pluralnya,
Nene? Ada. Kan ada them itu tadi. Nah, ini juga sama ya. Nah, yang selanjutnya. Kita lihat di sini. The king. The king could not hold it anymore. It sini, the king could not hold it anymore. Objek dia kan dari kata could not hold it. It ini objek. Singular juga kan? Objective pronoun. Tipenya personal pronoun singular juga tapi di object pronoun. Nah, begitu. Nanti ada yang oh ini tadi bukan. Lain lagi cerita. Jadi itu ya untuk pronoun. Nah, supaya bisa masuk ke materi nanti aja latihannya ya, atau mungkin nanti ini kita lihat ke apa sih subjek atau objek pronoun itu. Apa itu pronoun? Memang penting nggak sih dia dalam tata bahasa Inggris? Penting dia. Kan pronoun ini suka diganti-ganti oleh anak bahasa Inggris. Sama seperti mengganti-ganti gender kan. He, padahal namanya kan Seza kan, I met Seza, he, kayak gitu kan, ya, yeah, you know, tiba-tiba Seza berubah menjadi gendernya jadi he, gitu ya, ya kan, gitu, suka itu di dalam menulis, dalam bicara, suka subjeknya, kadang-kadang changing gender dengan mudahnya, gitu ya, she, jadinya he, nah itu jangan salah, nanti he dibilang she, itu hati-hati ketika ngomong. Nah, itu ketahuan ketika kita mengerti apa itu pronoun, ya. Oke. Okay? So we are going to continue ya. Kita lanjutkan ke theoretical-nya. Ini tadi ya. Oke. Okay. Ini sudah thank you di sini. So here we go. Pronoun. Ya. Kita akan cari apa definisinya, tipenya bagaimana, kemudian rules-nya seperti apa. Oke, okay. Yang di layar yang Anda lihat sekarang apa? Adakah PowerPoint-nya terlihat?
Belum, ma'am.
Belum ada share screen.
Oh, belum, ma'am, share screen. Baiklah. Really? Oke, okay. So here we go. Nah, sekarang you can see it now?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay. We are going to learn about pronoun. What is pronoun? Here we go. So, we're going to learn about its definition, So you have to understand the definition. Today you have to understand the definition, the types and the rules of using them. Okay, this is the story just we have just studied together. She, him, he and everything, yeah? So now we are going to okay, let's check. She had 6 older brothers. She di sini apa?
Subject.
Personal pronoun.
Okay, subject pronoun singular.
Yes.
Okay, kalau him?
Him object.
Object pronoun.
Personal pronoun.
Object pronoun singular.
Singular.
Singular. Yeah. Okay, what is pronouns? Let's see, Dice 2007 says that pronouns are
singular.
Okay, let's see. Can you see the new slide?
Yes,
okay. Pronouns, yeah? Pronouns are the words. Okay. So, pronouns are the words that are used in place of noun. Jadi, kata yang digunakan untuk menggantikan noun yang kemarin kita pelajari, ya kan? Ada, ya, okay. Contoh, we are going on vacation. So, we itu, it could be Adrianita and Cesar, we. Yeah? We is more than one person, we. Yeah? Room number two, don't tell me that you cannot go with us. So, ada you. You can be one, can be more than one people, right? Yes, okay, you. And then D, triply. This itu menunjuk. Nah, kemudian we run into each other at the mall. We lagi. Yeah. Ini saya belum checking ya. So now types of pronoun. Ada personal pronoun. Ada nanti ada lagi objective personal pronoun. Banyak dia ya. Kita lihat ini ada beberapa tipe sampai ya. Kita lihat di sini. Apaan ya? Nah, personal pronoun itu yang mana? Personal pronoun refers to a specific person or thing formed to indicate person number or gender. Nah, di sini atau I show you the book then. Wait ya. Oke. Okay. Masih kelihatan ceritanya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so you can see the book now. Right, okay. So, Wikia, this is the definition. So, there are many definition, but you can have more in the book, yeah? You can read more. So, here we have we, me, anybody, these, we, each other. Itu semuanya pronoun. Nah, types-nya menjadi personal pronoun, wait, personal pronoun yang subject ya, subjective, personal pronoun ada dua, subjective personal pronoun, subject itu berarti she, he, it, we, you, they, right, so that's the subject, position before the verb, right, so let's see, I, you, he, she, they, she, we, you, subject, now we're going to objective. Me, you and me. Oh, you love me. Misalnya itu. Or let's see, he loves me. So me is the objective personal pronoun. Yeah. Kalau you, subjective personal pronoun. Yeah, I love you. Sama. I subject, you object. Yeah. Kalau you love me.
You subject.
Me is the object. Okay, so not too difficult to know. You see, it is the Seema stole the Selkie's skin and forced her to live with him. Nah, her refer to Selkie's, him ke Seema's. ya kan? After reading the pamphlet, Judy threw it to the garbage can. Apa yang it ini merujuk kepada siapa?
Pamphlet.
Pamphlet. So very easy, pamphlet. Right? Okay. So very easy. Give the list to me. Me. Banyak kalau yang you and me itu seru. Possessive personal pronoun. Possessive apa?
Kepunyaan.
Kepemilikan. Ya. Possessive pronoun, yang personal pronoun, indicate that the pronoun is acting as the marker of the possession. Yang punya, who owns something. My?
My phone.
Yeah. Nah, let's see di sini. Dia ada, the possessive personal pronoun are mine, yours, hers, his, its, ours, and theirs. So, lihat ya, dia itu kalau I jadi mine, you jadi yours. The book is yours. Nah, dia pakai S ya, jadi itu at the end of the sentence. Contoh, the smallest gift is mine. Ya, the phone is mine. Mine-nya yang possessive. Personal pronoun. Kemudian, this is yours. Okay, this one, this mobile phone, this is yours. Yours. You belong to you. Kepemilikan ya. Paham ya? His, oh ini salah ketik lah. His is, oh ini, his is on the kitchen counter. His ini punya dia, kalau laki-laki ya. His. Kemudian theirs. Nah, theirs itu untuk yang punya orang rame-rame. The books are theirs, misalnya gitu. Jadi, nah ini tanda-tandanya dia pakai S di ujungnya dan dia biasanya di at the end of the sentence atau bisa juga di beginning of the sentence ya. Tapi mostly at the end of the sentence. Kemudian ada demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative means to show, menunjuk. Demonstrasi?
Ya,
to show. Ya. Yeah. Yeah. This and these itu dia. This phone. Nggak kelihatan ya. This phone. Ya. Yeah. This satu. This satu. Kalau this lebih dari?
Jamaknya banyak. Yeah.
These mobile phones dekat ya, these. Kalau jauh di situ,
those
mobile phone. This and that, gampang kan? This lesson is very easy actually. Interrogative pronoun. Nah ini mungkin yang agak beda ya, quite new for me ya. Interrogative pronoun is used to ask question. So the integrative pronouns itself is who, whom, which, what, and then ever, whoever, whomever, whichever, whatever, seperti itu ya. Nah, contoh di sini. Which wants to see the dentist first? The subject of the sentence. Kemudian, who wrote the novel Rockbound? Who? Who? Orang kan? Pasti orang kan? Ya. Yeah. Terus kemudian to whom do you wish to speak? Nah, kalau whom itu kan dia objek. Ya kan? To whom it may concern, misalnya gitu. Siapapun yang peduli dengan ini. Kalau di surat referensi di bagian atasnya to whom it may concern, itu siapapun yang akan membacanya yang memerlukan ini kayak gitu ya. Nah, whom is the object of the preposition to. Who subject dari compound verb will meet. Who will meet the delegates at the train station? Who subject kan? Yes? Itu dia. To whom ini ya. To whom juga. Whom is the object. Kalau whom dia pasti object. Ingat aja. Kalau who subject. Whom object. Gitu. Which untuk benda. Gitu, yang lain-lain gitu ya. Whichever. Which one I have to use? Whichever you want. Which mobile phone do you want? Whichever. Ya, itu sebagai subjek dia ya. Oke. Kemudian ada relative pronoun. Kalau relative, it's mean to relate ya. To relate. Sama di sini. Contohnya, you may invite whomever you like to the party. Whomever. Karena dia objek kan? Whomever. Dan dia jadi objek di situ. Dari objek sebagai you and may invite. Kemudian the candidate who wins. The candidate who wins the greatest popular vote is not always elected. Nah di sini, the relative pronoun who, subjek dari verbnya win. The candidate yang menang, yang menang popular vote akan is not always elected. Yeah. Karena orang yang popular biasanya bukan yang number one kan. Popular doesn't mean number one as well. Ya kan? Who. Kemudian whom lagi. Kemudian whoever. Whoever broke the windows will have to replace it. Whoever? Siapapun kan?
Siapapun.
Ya. Yeah. Whoever function sebagai subject dari kata broke. Kemudian the crate which was left in the corridor has now been moved into the storage closet. Nah, which benda ya. Kalau which untuk benda. Kemudian was left itu verbnya. Jadi berarti apa yang harus dilakukan mengidentify verbnya mana? Apakah dia subject atau dia object ya? Oke, kemudian indefinite pronoun. An indefinite pronoun is a pronoun referring to an identifiable but not specified person or things, ya. Di sini, the idea of all, any, none, some, the most common indefinite noun pronouns are all, another, any, anybody, sampai several, some, dan itu. Itu pronoun. Mulai agak itu ya. Di kepalanya. Masih oke ya, masih bisa following ya. Harusnya. Indefinite itu tadi tidak tentu. Belum jelas siaponyo. Nobody kan? Nobody. Who? You know. Another. Anybody. Each. Everybody. Everyone. Jadi kan enggak spesifik kan orangnya? Itu namanya indefinite. Next. Many. Nah ini contohnya. Many were invited to the lunch, but only 12 show up. Enggak disebutkan di depannya ini kan many students kan? Karena dia menjadi pronoun, maka dia ini sendiri sudah bermakna many, banyak yang diundang buat untuk menghadir lunch itu, tapi hanya 12 orang yang datang. Dia berfungsi sebagai subject. Many were invited, karena dia langsung ketemu were setelah itu. Dia pronoun, ya. Jadi nggak selalu many, harus many student, yang seperti itu nggak. Kalau many student, maka many-nya itu berfungsi sebagai adjektif. Oh, it is. Kalau adjektif kan ada word di depannya, many books. Atau tadi determiners itu tadi, many books, books. Tapi ini many sendirian, dia menjadi subject dan pronoun. Many were. Kemudian lagi, everything. The office had been searched and everything was thrown onto the floor. Everything. Semuanya. Kan gak spesifik kan? Everything apa? Nah, tapi ada kata itu dalam ini. Everything, none, everyone. Sini contoh, make sure you give everyone a copy. Dari indirect object dari kau tahu. A gift gitu ya. Nah, sampai. Kemudian ada reflexive pronoun. Reflexive itu yang me, myself. Pernah nonton film enggak? Judulnya me, kalau itu agak dibawa poetik gitu kayak gitu. Me, myself and I. Hah? Sendiri kan? Agak poetik dia kan? Me, myself and I atau I and Irene gitu ya. Nah, di sini kalau me itu the reflexive pronoun myself, yourself, herself, himself. Nah, yang kalian suka pakai itu adalah itself. Suka banget kan pakai kan ya itself, itself gitu kalau orang Indonesia speaking atau student bilang itself. Kadang-kadang dia enggak perlu pakai itself tapi dia pakai itself gitu. So, nanti you will encounter that. That's quite funny juga. Tapi it's okay. So, di sini diabetics give themselves. Ya. Yeah. Okay, the dean often does the photocopying herself. Berarti deannya laki-laki atau perempuan?
Perempuan.
Yeah. Karena herself. Yeah. Kalau dia laki-laki, deannya menjadi?
Himself.
Yeah. At the party, I ask myself. I ask myself why I had pets. Gitu. Jadi, himself juga. Nah, itu namanya reflexive pronoun. Karena merefleksi diri kita. I myself, ya. Yeah? He himself, she herself, they themselves. Apa lagi?
We.
We, our,
ourselves.
Iya. Pintar. Terakhir ada intensive pronoun. Sama seperti tadi di atas ini, dia reflexive pronoun kan? Nah, yang ini intensive pronoun, itu yang saya sebutkan tadi. I myself will cook the food. Menegaskan lagi ya. The prime minister himself. They themselves. Itu namanya intensive pronoun. Ngerti? Jadi nanti kan sudah mulai berbahasa seperti itu. I myself will pick up the book. Gitu ya. I myself... She herself will send the book to us, for example. Oh, kan ada
Indonesianya kayak aku sendiri yang akan mengambilnya gitu
kan. Iya, aku sendiri. Mm-mm. Nah, pernah kalian dengar ada juga yang penekanan tapi bukan sama dengan ini. Ada ini kan intensive pronoun ya. Ada dalam bahasa Inggris itu I love you. Itu biasa ya kata kalian jangan terlalu geli-geli amat dengar kata I love you biasa aja, ya. I love you. Ada kata lagi, I do love you. Mana yang lebih dalam?
I do.
I do love you. So, intense penekanan. Bisa juga, tapi do itu bukan nggak masuk sini, bukan intensive pronoun ya. Tapi juga ada dalam bahasa Inggris seperti itu. Penekanan. I love you. Biasa aja. I do love you. Please. Yeah. Nah. Hal seperti itu ada dalam bahasa Inggris. Oke? Okay? Jadi, so, ya, yeah, you sering nonton film lah. Misalnya kalau agak-agak klasik, you know. You nonton film, di YouTube ada kok. Pride and Prejudice. Prejudice, gitu ya. Terus kemudian, Becoming Jane. Kamu suka yang kayak gitu, yang romance kan? Jane Austen books. I love that. So, Becoming Jane. It's a pronoun sekarang, ya. Pronouns itu bisa jadi subject, we kan? Bila jadi subject pronoun juga bisa rename, may also be used to rename the subject. It was she who decided we should go to Hawaii. It was she. Dia yang sudah memutuskan kita tuh harus pergi ke Hawaii, kayak gitu ya. Terus kemudian lagi, indefinite pronoun, yang belum jelas tadi siapa orang. No one likes me. Misalnya gitu. Ya. Yeah. Terus kemudian object. This you, me, her. Seperti tadi sudah sebutkan. Nah, ini juga. They do not need apostrophe. Jangan pakai apostrophe ya. Kalau it's ini nih. Nggak pakai apostrophe. Kalau it's pakai apostrophe. Jadi dia it is. Kan? Kalau it's begini. It's tail. Kucing tuh goyang-goyangin ekornya gitu. Its tail. It refer ke siapa? Si kucing, right? The cat was its whisker. Gitu. Atau kucing. You know kucing, right? Don't say that you don't know kucing. So, this is what nanti akan Anda pahamin nih. Nah, jadi ada tabelnya nih ya. Personal pronoun, ada subject, ada object, yes. And then possessive adjective dan pronoun. Possessive adjective my menjadi mine. Your menjadi yours. Yeah. Kemudian reflexive menjadi I, me, my, mine, myself. Ya? Yeah? Themself, yourself. Ketika dia menjadi possessive pronoun, dia pakai S di ujungnya nih, nih. Most of them. Ketika dia menjadi possessive adjective, my book. Nah, my itu berarti dia possessive adjective, sama seperti its itu tadi. Nah, kalau dia object, atau subject. Sebenarnya kalau udah lihatin yang ujung ini, ringkasan ini aja udah ngerti sih sebenarnya. It's very easy though. Ya. Gitu. Coba nomor satunya. Kok exercise 3 langsung? Let's go to this one. Di buku ada itu, tapi di sini. Sini ngapain ya? Personal pronoun subject. Oh, my name is Sue. Itu si Sue kan? Jadi I kan? I am English. And this is my family. Number 2. My mom's name is Angie. Angie jadi gantinya apa?
She or he?
She is from Germany. Yeah. Bob is my dad. My dad?
He is
a waiter. On the left, you can see Simon. Simon?
He is my brother.
Sue and Simon.
They are twins.
Yeah. Yeah. Our dog is a girl, Judy. Judy?
It is
2 years old. Anda tahu dog itu di kalau di budaya sana karena saking sayangnya itu bahkan itu udah dianggap anak kan dan dipronounkan menjadi she sometimes. Jadi sudah punya misalnya nama gitu ya, Judy namanya. Nah, jadi she gitu. Mau jadi sebenarnya kan it's kan karena dia animal kan, tapi karena ada affection itu tadi jadi seperti itu. Sue, Simon, Angie and Bob.
They live in Canterbury.
Okay. Pintar. Terus, Canterbury.
It is not far from London.
Gampang kan? My grandparents live in London. My grandparents.
My grandparents.
They.
My grandparents can. My grandparents often come and see us. What can titik? Tell me about your family.
What can you tell me about your family?
You and me under the tree. Nah, sekarang personal pronoun object. My sister Jen loves book. This novel is for her. Yeah, let's see. My children like Disney film. The video is for
them.
Yeah. My brother Matt collects picture postcard. These postcard are for
him.
Yeah. Okay. My parents like Latin music. The CD is for
them.
I like watches. This nice watch is for
me.
For me lah, gitu ya. Okay. Nah, my wife and I love sweets. Itu sweet tuh candies yang manis-manis ya. These sweets are for
us.
Okay. Nomor 7. Baca.
My nephew likes cars.
The toy truck is for
him.
Okay. Him. Kemana dia tadi? Lanjut. My neighbor wants to go to California next year. The guidebook is for
her.
Yeah. 9.
Another souvenir.
Yes.
I don't know what to do with it, right?
Karena it itu souvenir ya. You know what? It's
for you.
For you. Misalnya itu saya pegang ini kan, you know what? What? Gitu kan? You know what? What? It's for you. Ini untuk kamu, gitu. Okay, ya? Three, exercise three, personal possessive adjective. So touchy. Where are you? Friends your. Now. Your friends your. Now. Here is a postcard from?
My
friend Peggy. Okay. She lives in Australia now with?
Her family.
Yeah. Husband work in Newcastle.
Her
kan?
Her
husband works in Newcastle. Next.
His company.
Okay, build ships. Okay, now.
Their
children. Okay, go to school in Newcastle. Did you?
My
husband and I want to go to Australia too. 8. We want to see Peggy and her family next winter. Okay, and then
our winter
wonderland. Okay, now because
it is their summer.
Iya, ini nih pokoknya their summer deh. Misalnya ada segerombolan orang Indonesia nih pergi ke Amerika pas summer. Oh, it's their summer gitu ya. Oke. Okay. Right? Ada lagi enggak sih? Masih ada. Mari lanjut. This book is
yours.
The ball is
mine.
The blue car is
ours.
Ours-nya pakai S enggak? Pakai ya. Okay. Ya, betul. The ring is
her.
Right. We met Paul and Jen last night. This house is
theirs.
Pakai S ya. The luggage is
his.
Yeah. The beaches are
hers.
Yes. Yeah. In our garden is a bird. The nest is.
This cat is ours.
This was not my fault. It was
yours.
Yours. It's not my fault. It's yours.
What's
yours? Yours, yeah. Anda suka British atau American?
American.
Yang suka nonton Harry Potter?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. Silahkan tiru aja itu nanti lama-lama kalian kayak British atau American gitu ya. So let's see number one. I did not want to believe it and then I saw the UFO. My son. The girl look at
herself.
Kan reflexive ya. The girl look at herself in the mirror. Freddy, you will have to do your homework.
Yourself.
Yourself-nya pakai L F atau F. Yang singular ya? Ya, self. Okay. You do not need to help them. They can do it
by themselves.
Yeah. I introduce
myself.
Kan suka tuh. May I introduce myself. My name is. Kemudian boys, can you make your bed?
Yourself.
Self-nya banyak apa satu?
Banyak.
Banyak ya. Ya pakai yourself ya. She made
herself
a pullover. Ya, dia membuatkan dirinya sendiri pullover tuh celana kodok ya. Kayak gitu. Enggak salah ya, pullover. What happened when a fighting fish see? Fish?
Itself.
Fish, yeah? Itself in the mirror.
Itself.
Ini fighting fish itu apa? Ikan cupang.
Yes.
Ikan adu. Okay. The father decided to repair the car.
By himself.
Himself.
Kok pakai for sih?
Himself.
Himself, ya. Langsung ya, nggak pakai for ya. Terus, we can move the table.
Ourselves.
Udah. Selesai masalah itu. Happy?
Happy.
That's it. So learning grammar you can make learning grammar happier. Selama ini student atau siapapun bang mengatakan learning grammar itu boring. Yes? Boring katanya. No, you can make it fun. Jadi by using story, it will make you happier in learning the grammar. And you got the explanation from the teacher. And the book is also can be studied by yourself though. Kalian bisa self study dengan buku itu. Itu saya berikan buku itu sudah bekal betul untuk itu. Jadi nanti kalian nak ngasih les itu gampang. Oke lah, saya ikhlaskan.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Nanti udah bisa mulai ngeles-ngeles kan, bukan ngeles-ngeles yang itu ya, tapi ngasih les ke anak SD misalnya kayak gitu kan, sambil kuliah sambil ini ya udah kasih les, bisa dapat cuan kan?
Cuan.
Dapat
cuan.
Untung jajan, karena jajan tidak keluar kan, kalau selama pandemi ini kan belajarnya di rumah aja. Jadi jajan bensin tidak keluar, uang jajan itu nggak keluar, biasanya begitu kan?
Paham. Ya, ya benar mem.
Ya aku tuh paham gitu, aku tuh paham kamu. Because I was in your position like 23 years ago. So when I go to school, I will get money. If I'm not going to school, I didn't get money. Just at home, eat everything at home. You can have it seperti itu, ya. Jadi anak-anak online sekarang itu suka bilang, "Mam, kami bosan belajar online di rumah terus ngadapin laptop.
Uang jajan
tidak keluar." Sabar ya. Jadi uang bensin Anda mungkin dibantukan untuk membeli kuota. Jangan lagi bilang, "Mam, saya nggak bisa ikut Zoom karena kuota dari Kemdikbudnya habis." Terus, emangnya Kemdikbud harus mensupport you selamanya untuk Zoom-nya kan? Nggak, dikasih namanya juga bantuan kan? Bantuan tuh ya.
Karena Himagres belum kan?
Nggak tahu. Belum mungkin kayak belum gitu ya. Udahlah, santuy aja. Kuota beli yang mana? Kalau misalnya di rumah bisa pasang wifi, minta sama untuk pasang wifi, kalau enggak ya pakai kuota kayak gitu, gimana lagi. Jadi uang jajan yang selalu bolak-balik ke UNIP selama ini dipakai itu ya sudah, belikan kuota kayak gitu. Nah, sabar ya, sabar belajar dan tetap harus rajin belajar walaupun pandemik seperti ini, walaupun mungkin sometimes saya tuh mabuk Zoom gitu kan tahu mabuk Zoom. Saya tuh sering juga ngalamin mabuk Zoom. Saya tuh sudah selesai sampai dari pagi sampai sore udah tetap kapar. Mabuk Zoom jadi teacher itu lebih berat daripada jadi student kan? Dua kali lebih berat kan? Karena jadi teacher kita jelaskan segala macam. Paling kan dengar aja. Gitu. Wah, terus mencernanya. Makanya ketika ada yang Zoom terus kalian tidak fokus itu, ya udah keluar aja, buang-buang kuota kamu. Ngapain? Kalau memang dia tidak fokus, ngapain hadir hanya untuk hadir di Zoom saja tapi kamu tidak belajar, kayak gitu kan? Rugi kan? Mending diselamatkan. Saya tadi menyelamatkan kuota dia. Daripada dia tidak fokus, apa udah masuk lagi?
dia izin ke Seza, mem. Gimana tuh, mem? Yang kayak gitu dimasukin hadir apa gimana, mem?
Dia izin apa katanya?
Lah, Seza, Z, Grego izin. Hmm. Gak dibilang apa, izin aja.
Ya sudah, izin ya. This easy. Karena mungkin dia memang tidak bisa kuliah itu kan sambil ngobrol itu tadi kan. Ngapain masukannya cuma untuk ini aja. Nah, ini Arya ini ada nggak orangnya nih? Arya Yuda Eka, ada?
Ada,
kenapa? Kamu belum mandi?
Sinyalnya, mem.
Oh gitu. Zulfikar, Fadil?
Ada, mem.
Ada. Oke. Cek lah. Kalau misalnya nggak kekurangan kuota, berarti belum mandi. Jadi kalau yang tutup-tutupnya berarti belum mandi. Karena sudah suruh mandi, gitu kan? Halo Agung, Agung from Jember.
Ya, Mam.
Cerah di sana?
Alhamdulillah cerah, Mam.
Oke, di sini juga ya. So, jaga sehat ya.
Siap.
Nah, besok itu sudah untuk yang ini, untuk materi hari ini. Adakah kalian mau bertanya?
About indefinite pronouns. What is the difference about every and each?
Every dan each.
Yes, ma'am.
Every. Semua. Ya. Kalau each, one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Each of. Yeah. Each and every, kadang-kadang tuh itu ada kan di bahasa gitu kan, each and every one of you, go there gitu. Setiap kamu orang, semuanya, setiap, jadi every, semua kan. Kemudian semua itu kan ada terbagi-bagi lagi kan, misalnya 30 kan ada satu anak dua tengah, each of the student, satu gitu ya. Jadi suka itu, nanti suka everything, everybody. Nah, ingat, each, everybody, itu tuh single. Ya, yeah? Everyone, single ya. Oke, okay, ada lagi?
Ma'am? Okay, ma'am, before that, I will introduce myself. My name is Muhammad Hikmah Faransa, and my nickname is Huma. So I wanna ask about a job. So ada subjek untuk pekerjaan seperti reporter dan manager itu kan biasanya gendernya tidak dikenalkan, itu tidak dikenali maksudnya. Jadi untuk penggantinya itu kita it atau they, mem. Itu sering simposium mengenai kata ganti untuk sebuah pekerjaan yang tidak jelas atas gendernya. Bagaimana, mem, itu, mem?
Pekerjaan?
Yes, mem. Seperti reporter.
Reporternya orangnya.
Ya orangnya, mem.
It depends, pasti ketahuan kan reporternya cewek apa cowok.
Misal dalam sebuah kalimat, mem?
Kalau nggak tahu ketahuan ya sudah, he atau she, up to you. Nanti biasanya konteks akan memberikan ini. Konteks kalimat selanjutnya akan memberikan clue, apakah dia she atau he.
Berarti bukan it, itu, mem, ya?
Kalau orangnya reporters, he, she.
Berarti bebas milih antara dua itu, mem, ya?
Ya.
Antara she dan he.
Ya, it depends. Nanti biasanya kan kalau kalimat itu pasti dia punya konteks. Nah, konteksnya itulah yang akan membantu Anda ada kalimat setelahnya atau sebelumnya. Nanti akan kalau ada satu teks itu kan pasti akan ketahuan apakah itu she atau he, kayak gitu. So, kalimat pun kadang-kadang kita tidak hanya bisa melihat dalam satunya. Kadang konteks ikut dalam memberi makna pada satu kata. Gitu ya. Gitu, Hikmah. Okay. Next. Macam saya. Okay, ya. So, do you have any more question about this?
Ayman.
Aldi.
Itu kan misalkan ada kalimat this phone is mine. Apa bedanya itu mem sama it's my phone? Mine sama my. Nah, mungkin lebih tolong dijelaskan dulu.
This phone is mine. Terus
sama it's my phone gitu kan. Kan ada beda mine sama my, tapi artinya itu kan sama punya saya maksudnya. Handphone.
Ada yang bisa bantu jelaskan? Ayo. This phone is mine. Iya, oke, okay, Tiara, silakan.
I think this because I hold it. This.
Yeah.
This is my phone. Because mm-mm. I hold it.
Mm-mm.
But it itu itu HP-nya.
It's my phone. Ya, jadi gini. Tuh, good try. This phone is mine, this. Kata pronoun this. Demonstrative pronoun tadi. It's. It itu it bukan it dengan s tapi it saja. Itu subject. Ya, it is my phone. Nah, it ini apa tadi? Subject, pronoun singular. Ya kan? Nah, kalau this tadi demonstrative pronoun. Tuh, beda ya. Tapi maknanya sama. This is my phone. It is my phone. This phone is mine. This phone is mine, kepemilikan. Kalau it is my phone, saya menyatakan ini telepon saya. Telepon ini punya saya. Itu aja. Kalimatnya beda ininya aja. Pasif dengan aktif aja. Oke? Okay? Next.
Jadi mem yang punyanya Ellie tadi itu juga bisa jadi intensive noun enggak mem? Itu kan yeah. Every and each kan? Itu kan kayak hampir sama kayak penekanan jatuhnya.
Each and every enggak, tapi dia enggak disebut masuk jadi intensive pronoun. Each and every. Kalau tadi itu I myself, gitu kan? You yourself, they themselves. Itu kan tadi reflexive ya. Dan dia menjadikan intensifier, menekankan kembali gitu. Okay? What's next? So, this actually this second after noun, this pronoun is quite easy ya, tapi selama ini mungkin Anda tidak tahu itu namanya pronoun, right? You just know it is subject. This is subject, something, right? So, what about the nouns previously? Sudah selesai, sudah mengerti ya, tuntas ya dengan noun ya. Banyak macamnya kan? Yeah. Nah, karena nanti next week kita akan masuk kepada dihafal tapi dimengerti. Menghafal dengan mengerti itu beda. Memorizing kalau itu, tapi kalau understanding itu beda. Jadi yang harus Anda lakukan adalah to understand. Kalau sudah paham, no one can take it from you. You know? Tapi kalau memorize, nanti Anda grogi, ada segala macam, hilang itu hafalan, right? Nah, so, sekarang levelnya, not to memorize, but to understand. So, that's why, whenever your teacher is explaining it to you, you need to really, really listen to it. Or you have to really, when you read something, then you really read it. Seperti itu ya. Comprehension yang diperlukan, understanding. Not memorizing. Ya, ini kalian yang masih satu. Belajar itu bukan hanya tentang memorizing. Belajar itu adalah untuk memahami dan cara untuk memahaminya dengan membaca dan memasukkannya ke dalam kepala kalian each and every day. Each and every day you have to study about English language teaching because you are being prepared to be an expert in English language teaching yang nanti bisa mengajarkan kembali kepada orang. Jangan sampai bahasa Inggris diri sendiri saja tidak beres. Cak Manu nak ngajarkan ke orang. Nah, ya? Ya kan? Khusus
tanya sebentar kan? Untuk yang absent itu Seza absenkan yang dari MBKM juga enggak?
Iya dong.
Gabung tak?
Iya. Oke, absen. Apa lagi? Irfan Torik. Ya, nikmati ya. Kalian berzoom-zoom sepanjang hari ya. Jangan lupa makan.
Ya, kan.
So, have a great day lah. See you again next week.
See you, man.
This week you have no assignment ya. Belum ada assignment-nya kan? Kecuali logbook ya. Sudah. Oke. Okay. So, bye-bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Be good. Jadi anak baik. Belajar yang rajin. Ya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Yuk, assalamualaikum.